Welcome, myself Anush Tiwari and I am a student of Faculty of Engineering and Technology, University of Lucknow, and today I am going to present the presentation on self-healing concrete. In this presentation, I am going to give brief introduction about self-healing concrete. After that, we know different types of self-healing concrete, that is autogenous healing concrete, chemical additives based healing concrete, bio-based healing concrete. And after that, we know the advantages and disadvantages of self-healing concrete, and also the difference between self-healing concrete and traditional concrete, and applications and uses of self-healing concrete. And in end, we will come together to the conclusion. Self-healing concrete is recently emerging cement-based technology in the construction industry that is exactly as the name suggests. It repairs itself as it undergoes cracks, abrasions, and deteriorations throughout its life. It is designed to reduce the effect and propagation of cracks as they appear. It has the potential to longer lasting structures while providing a higher level of serviceability for the users. The picture below shows the self-healing concrete as it goes through the healing process. Self-healing properties have been dated back to Roman times, such as Trajan's Market in Rome, where the structure has remained standing for roughly 1900 years. There are three types of producing self-healing concrete that will be discussed in this presentation. The first one is autogenous healing concrete, chemical additive-based healing concrete, bio-based healing concrete. In first type of self-healing concrete is autogenous healing concrete. In autogenous healing concrete is a natural process that occurs when the cracks propagate in any concrete structure by adding surplus of cementitious material. Not all of the mixture will have undergone hydration in the initial concrete curing process. When the concrete cracks or deteriorates, the excess cement is exposed to moisture in the air, enabling it to hydrate long after the initial setting of concrete. This process fills the small fractures, discontinuing the propagation of larger fractures and impeding the penetration of water from the environment. This method is most effective when the concrete is exposed to humid air, allowing the hydration process to continue as long as there is an excess of unhydrated cement. The second type of self-healing concrete is chemical additives based healing concrete. In chemical additive based healing concrete, chemicals can be incorporated into the concrete mixture in order to produce self-healing effects. The agents are retained in capsules among the concrete until they are broken by some form of external mechanism, such as physical or chemical weathering or a palm rupture. The chemical from a gel-like substance that fills the crack and sealing it from the external environment. Current research shows that the chemical additive based healing is best form of producing self-healing concrete because the no other factors of the concrete mix design need to be changed in order to add the capsules. And also the self-healing concrete is the most cost-effective concrete. The third type of self-healing concrete is bio-based healing concrete. In bio-based healing concrete, the incorporation of bacteria in the cement paste during the mixing of the concrete, these bacteria are also mixed with an inorganic nutrient called calcium lactate. The ability of the member to repair its own defects will yield a longer service life and increase durability and an increase in safety aspects involved with the member. The bacteria undergoes metabolic process inducing a precipitation of calcium carbonate in the form of limestone. This precipitation builds up and acts as effective barrier and shielding the crack from further deterioration. In bio-based healing concrete, the bacteria will survive 200 years in the concrete and it takes 3 weeks to seal the cracks. Benefits and disadvantages of self-healing concrete. There are various benefits associated using self-healing concrete structure. The first is it is more sustainable than conventional concrete through self-healing properties. It can effectively double its lifespan, having longer-lasting structures, would reduce the frequency of demolishing concrete-based buildings and members of the dust and members, the dust of which releases harmful pollutants into the environment. Further, it also decreases the demand of cement and also lowering CO2 emission by 5%. Secondly, there is financial benefits such as it reduces the needs of replacing the broken structure, rehabilitate cracking defective structures, perform routine maintenance. By these, the structure is more economic, become more economic. Improved structural integrity of reinforced concrete members. One of the causes of deterioration in concrete construction is from moisture penetrating through the cracks and rusting out the rebar. This greatly reduces the moment resistance of the member by filling the cracks through the earlier discussed self-healing techniques such as autogenous healing concrete, chemical additive-based healing concrete, bio-based healing concrete. The member will maintain their structural integrity longer, providing a safer product for the people utilizing structure. And it has also aesthetics benefits such as it reduces rust staining from rebar exposed to moisture and also smooth structure surface free of patching. Self-healing concrete have various disadvantages. The first is the material cost in initial process is high and it is not widely implemented because of lack of awareness, and self-healing concrete has limited case studies and modern research. The strength of self-healing concrete is compromised if self-healing agents exceeds 20% of mixture. Self-healing concrete versus traditional concrete. In self-healing concrete, the cracks are repaired by itself, whereas in traditional concrete, the cracks are not repaired by itself. We can use extra concrete or mortar to repair crack. In self-healing concrete, it is eco-friendly in nature, so it cannot harm the environment. Whereas traditional concrete is not eco-friendly and also harm the environment because for its production, emission of CO2 is very much, which can harm the environment. In self-healing concrete is cost-effective, so we can easily use in construction work. And in self-healing concrete, the regular inspection of concrete does not require. Whereas in traditional concrete, the maintenance cost is very high. In self-healing concrete, the compressive strength of self-healing concrete is improved by 14.92% by adding bacteria Blechsius subtilis JC3 as compared to traditional concrete. In traditional concrete, the regular inspection or routine maintenance of concrete is required, whereas in self-healing concrete, the skilled labor is required for a mixing, and in traditional concrete, no skilled person is required for mixing. The applications of self-healing concrete is used in various places such as roads, buildings, foundation walls. Recently, the use of self-healing concrete in Beijing Hangzhou Canal. The Beijing Hangzhou Canal is one of the main waterways for inland waterway transportation in China, and it is the channel with the highest cargo flow density and the busiest transport in Jiangsu province. The Mengduo River is located in Yangzhou City, Jiangsu province, China, which connects the Beijing Hangzhou Canal to the north and the Hangjiet River to the south. It is a diversion channel in the Hangzhou section of the Beijing Hangzhou Canal and is also the main water delivery channel for the east route of south to north water transfer project, which has the function of water transportation, flood discharge and drainage. Self healing concrete was mainly used at the junction of the sidewall and the bottom plate of the sluice chamber in Beijing Hangzhou Canal in China. The figure shows that the Beijing Hangzhou Canal, where the self healing concrete is used, is shown in the red color. And the conclusion of self-healing concrete is that self-healing concrete is an innovative technology raising interest today, and it can be produced autogenously, chemically or biologically, but among these three, the chemically additive based healing can be produced economically, and it provides more durable structures around the world. Thank you everyone.